Greetings everyone, as always, Ryan Callahan, Wealth Planner with Northeast Planning Associates, here with another video of Everything Money. Today we're talking term life insurance, and guess what? It sounds exactly like what it is. You're buying a life insurance policy on yourself or on a loved one that will last a specific period of time. The question you have to ask yourself is, how much do you need? How much are you willing to pay for the policy? And for what term do you need the insurance for? Well, let's start with the first question, how much do you need? Most people look at it as a round number. I'd like to have $1 million of whole life insurance. You know, there's the 10 times income theory as well. We want to have 10 years of your income to replace in a death benefit. Or you can also get very specific on what number you need. Let's use an example here. Let's say you just started family. So you bought the house, okay? You have the kids. So here's the family. And you have a certain number. Now that number could change. You may need a certain dollar amount here, let's say it's $1 million, because God forbid if something happened to you tomorrow, you have a lot of needs. You have very young children. You're trying to replace the cost for the mortgage. You're also trying to make sure that you're ensuring your kids have college money, things like that. But this number could change as time goes on. 15 years from now, you may have taken off a hefty chunk of your mortgage. That payment could be significantly less. Your kids have grown up a little bit more and you've saved for their college through a 529. You've also saved for yourself and your spouse through retirement savings and built an emergency fund. So 15 years from now, your number may not be $1 million. Your number could be $500,000. Well, in this situation, it could make sense to do what's known as a yearly renewable term, which means that you're gonna have $1 million of life insurance. You're gonna have a certain premium on that amount, and that number is gonna continue to increase over time. So 15 years from now, if you look back and say, you know what, right now where I am, I don't need $1 million of life insurance, I actually only need $500,000, well, you would apply for the $500,000 policy, and once you got it, you would let your $1 million policy lapse and then just move on going forward. Now, what's the only issue with this example? Well, God forbid something happens to you here from a health standpoint. And I'm not talking about death. I'm talking about if you have a chronic illness or if you're on a certain prescription medication. This could be a situation where your premiums may be significantly higher if you go to reapply for life insurance with those pre-existing conditions, or worst case scenario, you may not be able to even get life insurance depending on your health situation. So there is some risk in this strategy. What could make more sense, what eliminates this concern? It would be buying a specific term amount starting back here. So with $1 million, instead of doing a yearly renewable, you want to lock in that premium for the next 20 years, let's say. So you buy a 20-year policy. Now, at the same point in time, 15 years from now, if your needs change and you don't have any pre-existing conditions, you apply for the $500,000 life policy, and then you simply just let the 20-year policy lapse. Now, here's the give and take. With the yearly renewable term, your premium is going to be less than what it would be if you just bought the 20-year fixed premium. But at the same point in time, as we continue to move along here, 15 years from now, what do you think is going to happen with the premiums? That's right. The yearly renewable term is now going to be more expensive 15 years from now than the locked-in premium that you got 15 years prior. So it's all give and take. And even though term insurance is very basic in terms of what it is, it's straight insurance. Once again, there is no cash value in this policy. We still need to plan for different situations and what can happen and what's going to be the best strategy for you and your family. The other thing to keep in mind is that this policy is yours. We work with many families who also get group life insurance benefits through work, and it's a great benefit to have. However, those policies are owned by the employer. And if you leave the company, the policy will not go with you. Buying an individual policy on yourself ensures that you will always have coverage regardless of employment. So as always, we want to thank you for joining us for another session of Everything Money. For any questions on this, please feel free to contact us directly at 833-CAL-PLAN. That's 833-225-7526. Or visit our website, www.callahanplans.com. We look forward to continuing the conversation with you. Take care.